Alright, welcome everybody. Today's video is on the Canadian IMP, or MRE for those around the world. This is smoked meat with demi-glaze sauce. Montreal smoked meat, it's very similar to corned beef, I would say, but it is spiced somewhat differently. Some people argue it's the same thing, whatever. This is from an expiry of 2013, so relatively recent. This is now 2015. So let's get into this one, empty all the ingredients out, see what's going on, and do some taste testing. Come with me. All right, let's get this open here. The Canadian IMP comes in a foil-backed paper bag. Foil's on the inside. I haven't yet tested the waterproofness or water resistance of this bag. You can see how the ingredients are laid out in there. I'll go in a moment and I get my hands out of the way. Right. There we go. So we have the two mains. One is normally the meal, and the other is, the entree, and one is an accompaniment, like a dessert of sorts, sometimes fruit puree or fruit salad or crumble or something of that nature. So I'm going to take these ingredients out just one by one, and we'll have a quick look at them. Alright, so on top we get the little candy, the book of matches, we get a Hershey's bar. This is creamy milk chocolate Hershey. There you go, one Hershey's bar. That's a new one to me, I haven't had it before. We have a Nescafe caramel flavor, usually a coffee-based product. And on the back, I'm just going to look here, contains milk, which it looks like an allergen warning because it's in numerous languages afterwards. And best before end of 09-2013 at 10:46. We're beyond that now. Put that to one side. And we have the dental gum. We have raspberry jam. It's a little bit different packaging than the last few I've had. And this is Wings Food Products, Toronto, Canada. So they're manufactured in Canada. This date is December, the 244th day that was manufactured. Other packets in here, we have mustard. Of course we do. This mustard goes on corned beef well. That is the 276th day of 2012. This is another mustard. It's the same manufacture date. We have peanut butter. That is 263rd day of 2012. I'm sorry I didn't give you a close-up on the mustard. There we go. Just randomly grabbing packages here. We have another beverage or two. Peach sports drink. Now I mentioned in one of my other videos, I really wish if I had input that they would put two different ones in there. That way if you don't happen to like peach, which I'm not a big fan of, you could have the other one. This really opens you up to, if you're lucky enough to have a partner or other people around you, to trades. We have the mashed potatoes, which is why this is borderline MRE, because it's not a meal ready to eat. This component is not ready to eat. You have to add water to that. So I don't mind it. I still think it's a reasonable thing to ask. Warm water is not that difficult in most situations. The nutritional information, I'll hold that up for you here. Get ready to pause it if you need to. And I'll try and frame the ingredients list in here. Again, pause it if you need to. Okay, so this one you fill to this line with hot water and mix. That's it. Okay, we get there. We also have the bread. I don't mind the tank treads. We'll open that up in a minute. It does have nutritional information on the back of this one, so I'm going to hold that up to you as well. Get ready to pause. I hope that's all framed in there. And then there's the ingredients. Beverage bag. For the chocolate drink, if you have one, you fill to this line after adding the powder. And for the fruit beverages, you add to that line after adding the powder. That's the peach sports drink we saw earlier. We have a nice clean towelette. We've got the handy long spoon. And we have the, I believe this is a square foot heavy paper towel. Good stuff. We'll put it over here. Now, let's get to the important stuff. Oh, pardon me. Almost always forget the toothpick. Pointy at both ends. All right, so now we get to the mains. This is the dessert, sliced apples. And it is manufacture date of 328th day of 2012. It has some information that I'll hold it up. Hopefully the focus picks up on that. Ingredients are sliced apples, salt, calcium chloride, sodium metabisulfate, water, sugar, ascorbic acid, and a warning, contains sulfites. There you go. Okay, that'll go up here. The next we have smoked meat. Right on. Let me give you the ingredients on there. First, the nutritionals. Then we have the ingredients list. Feel free to pause. Hopefully that's in focus. All right, and that's going to go here. So I'm going to go off to the hot water and warm up the main. I'm not going to warm up the apples. I've done it in other videos, and the foil package inside, it says you don't have to bother. So I'll be back. We'll fill the plate out, and we'll do some taste testing. All right, so while we're waiting for that meal to heat up, we're going to get into some of these sides. Now here we have the bread. Always make sure you locate the do not eat, because you don't want to eat that. So these breads are notorious. Give it the squeeze test. You can see it comes back, so that's not bad. I'm going to give it a taste by itself. Good texture. Tastes like basically you're eating the front and the end of a piece of bread, or a loaf of bread, because you've got crust pretty much all the way around. But we're going to save that to go with the meat. I don't mind these. Some people love them, some people hate them. I'm in the middle of the road. I'm just easy going. Next one is sliced apples. Pour that in there. Grab a tear notch. That one we're hoping pretty easy today. And there you go. Slicey apples. In scoop. A couple more on the bottom. Get it all. Get all that 1,200 calories. Okay. This I'm going to save till later. I can't save it for forever, but I might save that for my wife. I'm going to get some water, and we're going to make the mashed potatoes. Right back. All right, water's boiled, so we're going to come in here, tear across. Nope, didn't get down to the line, so that's okay. Waking up. Try and let you have a peek. It's just powdered mashed potatoes with some little bits in there, so I think that's possibly onion. So we'll take this, we'll hold it deftly at the sides because this is just boiled water. I'll try and get it up to that level where it says it's supposed to be. Okay, almost quite, not quite there. And it's a little bit over the line, so I used about 3/4 of a cup of water. Open the package up so I can get into the corners. And I'm going to go ahead and stir. The last one I had of these worked really well, but I didn't get down to the corners well enough. So if you see how I'm holding it by this edge, boiled water is stankin' hot. But if this is all I have to do to chef up my meal, pretty sure I can live with that. So mix really well. All the stuff in the corners. Check my level. And I might have been a bit stingy on the water, so I'm going to go back in there. Another little bit. So now we're darn near a cup of water. That's working a little bit better. Just takes a minute to get all that powder mixed in. I will keep mixing this until I'm done, and I'll be right back. Alright, so it's thickened up pretty nicely. There might still be a bit of extra moisture, but I'm going to take this and put it in my handy serving tray here. See how much of it I can get out of there before it becomes messy. I hope you can see that. good consistency, pretty well mixed. I only did about another 20 seconds after I paused you guys. Now you can see the advantage of the long spoon. I know some people question why there's such a long spoon in these packages, but you make it universal and it all works. There's some powder. Now you can see how I thought that was really well mixed. But there's my corners. That's most of it. So you see the powder here? I'm gonna mix that through. Hopefully that picks up nicely. Still got some moisture out there. It is, I will admit, somewhat difficult to mix in that bag because it's got corners. A different pouch might work, or if even it was a horizontal pouch versus a vertical pouch, that might not be a bad idea as well. That's pretty well incorporated. There we go. Strong enough to stick a spoon in it. I'm going to go get the main, and I'll be back with you in a moment. All right, well, I have returned with the main, the smoked meat. And it seems like there's a fair bit of air in here, so it had a hard time getting that all in the water. But you saw me when I put it into the water, and I went at an angle. So what I did after 5 minutes is I turned it around. Most of the product is, because it's a big slab, wow, down there, the hot part. So without further ado, we will get the top. Just like that. A lump of meat. Get you in there. And we will gently get that all out for you. That smells absolutely delicious. I can smell the corned beef. I can smell that gravy. It looks good too. Well, I'm going to have to start with the mashed potatoes because that's how I'm going to clean this spoon off. So let's take a bite of that just as it is. Yeah, perfect. Tastes like any commercial mashed potato mix. Yeah, no complaints on that. I'm going to try that. Well, first let me try it by itself. Try a scoop of the sauce. That's a nice au jus type sauce. A little bit salty, but that has to do with personal preference, so I'm not going to complain about it. I'm going to get this meat dispersed. So this is sliced similar to a sandwich meat. Oh, you can really smell that corned beef smell. Okay, sorry, Mom, I'm gonna use my fingers. I only have the one tool. So you can see it unfold to slices, or at least pieces. I'm gonna try this one over here. It looked like it was spoonable. Yep, really nice. It's good smoked meat. That is good texture. Still firm. Good mouthfeel, a little bit salty for my personal taste, but other than that, that tastes really good. I highly recommend this one. I'm going to enjoy finishing this off. And that's a fair amount of meat too. I would say that's probably in the range of 100 to 150 grams, well maybe 125 grams of meat. So that's enough for a couple of big sandwiches. You could use a knife, cut the bread by half and make a sandwich out of it, but I prefer to eat these around the plate, so to speak. So. Mashed potatoes, good. Smoked meat, good. Try the apple slices next. There we go. Just like anything you get out of a can, very sweet, soft consistency. It's tasting and feels in the mouth. Just like when it, like I said, anything out of a can you'd buy yesterday or tomorrow. So, no problem on those. Now I'm going to try adding some of the mustard. Okay, stick with me. And the mustard. So the peanut butter and the jam are going to have to go here. I'm going to try the raspberry jam. I don't think I've tried that one yet on camera. So, feels good. No dry bits. It's a 15-gram bag, so it's a pretty healthy serving. Open that up. I'm going to reserve it over here, just in case there's anything wrong with it. See, I'm careful here. If I had just taken this and squirted it right onto the meat and there was something foul or wrong or untoward about the mustard, you'd bugger up the whole plate pretty much. So if I put it over here, it gives me a chance to test it and look at it first. Even if it's fine, I can mix it in as much as I like. I'm gonna give that a taste to see how potent it is. It tastes like any yellow mustard you'd find on a store shelf today. So I'm going to add this in. Tried the bread already. Let's try this raspberry jam. It feels good. There's no hard parts in it. It doesn't feel soupy. There we go. Spread that on some bread. Just going to do the quick and dirty version, guys, because I want to eat, and this doesn't need to have a lot of technical detail. There you go. That's fine. It's tastes like a sweet jam, and consistency is good. Color is good. Let me see there. No degradation. Looks just fine. It's even got some little seedy bits in it. Excellent. I will reserve the beverage, this one, for another day. But I will put together the sports drink, and then I'm going to tuck into supper. All right, welcome back. I'm done eating. So here we go into the dessert, which is a Hershey bar, creamy milk chocolate, with caramel in the middle, I guess. And I already mentioned expiry on this, or if I didn't, best before December 2013. That was a while ago. Let's see if I can get this open with my slippery fingers here. There we go. This is 2 years overdue, but you can see there's no discoloration or oxidation of the chocolate. It's not leaking anywhere. It wasn't squooshed. So that means that the protective casing, that bag, is pretty reasonable. I'm gonna break one open here. See, the caramel is still quite pliable. And I'm going to taste it, just because I have to. Sorry, it's hard to talk with caramel in my mouth. As good as anything you get at the corner store, and tastes as fresh as the day it was made. All right, here we go for the peach beverage. So you take out the bag. I mentioned the two fill lines. It has a bottom, then when it opens up, it's like the other bottles you can get, it opens up into a standing bottom. I still find them a bit of a devil to drink out of, but the best way, once they're full, I've found, is to squeeze it this way and put your mouth here and drink. If you try and drink from this side, you're going to end up wearing some of it. So try and get to that side over there. So the first thing to do is to put in the peach powder, get that down on the bottom. Tears easily. Open that up, and you see the white powder. That smells like peach. Okay, we'll get it all in there. That's all of it. Sorry, just bumped your shot there. Find they open up to a point, and then you get there. And that, my friends, is about the most perfect pour I've had yet on one of these bad boys. Let me open it up all the way and prove to you that I'm not perfect. So I'm going to have to put a bit more in there. That is about just right. So we're going to seal it up. We're going to leave the air in here because you need room to mix with. So that's sealed up real well. You can see that most of the powder dissolved already. But we're going to shake that up, as Taylor Swift says. Okay, that's a pretty thorough shaking. Just looking to see if there's anything left in the bottom for solids, but it looks like everything is dissolved. So now for the important part. The taste test. First off, the smell. It doesn't smell overpowering, but it does have a peach flavor to it. That's actually palatable. It's a hint of peach flavor, just a little bit. It's not an overpowering like some of the bottled juices can be. So that's your sports drink. That's your peach sports drink. And I'll put that off to the side. And I'm actually going to chill that in the fridge before I drink the rest of it, because the water I use was room temperature. I like these kind of drinks nice and cold. So today we're going to do a bit of an encore. We have the toothpick, that's self-explanatory. We have the dental gum. Now, I've just eaten the chocolate a couple minutes ago, so I'm not even going to try that. But the dental gum, it's just a very benign flavored little chiclet that I believe has some sort of teeth cleaning additives to it, although I haven't been able to find any exact science online about that. I'm just going to try out the handy wipe, a bit of a citrus scent, and to get some mustard or some stuff on your fingers, on your hands, or if you're worried about cleaning, you can clean before you eat. If you've been out in the field and you've got dirt under your nails, clean up whatever surfaces are going to touch your food. You'll be good to go. That's pretty sturdy. Yeah, you're going to pull pretty hard before that rips, so not bad at all. Last thing we'll do, oh, my wife would kill me if she saw me doing this in the house. I'm going to try a match. Stand back. And I have water at the ready. No problem. There you go. So everything works. Everything tasted good. Everything was very palatable. So that's the smoked meat meal. Thanks for joining me, and we'll see you on the next one.